So hello friends, welcome back once again in the next series of React Native. So it's the first lecture of the React Native. So it's the official link of the React Native. So all the topics mentioned in the React Native official document we will cover in this series. So we will cover components, APIs, architecture. So all the topics we will discuss in this series. So in this series we will check how React Native apps work in Android and iOS. So we will cover all exercise and all interview related questions of React Native. So first we will discuss what is React Native. So React Native actually launched in 2015. React Native is a popular open source mobile application development framework. So it's a framework created by Facebook. So React Native is a mobile application development framework and it is created by Facebook. So React Native uses JavaScript to create cross-platform mobile application with true native capabilities. So here JavaScript is a language. So it is a language like Swift and Objective-C we use in native iOS application, and Kotlin and Java we use native Android application. So here we use JavaScript as a language for cross-platform mobile application. So the next question is that what is cross-platform development? So cross-platform development is building apps that is compatible with multiple hardware platform like iOS, Android and other platform like Windows. So here cross-platform development means that it is compatible with multiple development platform. So in React Native with single code we can create multi-platform apps like iOS app, Android app and other platform apps. So the main point is that here we use single code and we can create multi-platform apps. So React Native is a framework for building native apps using JavaScript. So actually here we are using the JavaScript but we are creating native apps like we create in Swift and Objective-C. So in React Native we can also create native app but using JavaScript. So it is the plus point of React Native that we don't need to learn separate languages like Swift, Objective-C for iOS, Swift and Objective-C for iOS development and Java and Kotlin for Android. So these are the languages we used for iOS and Android development. But in React Native, we need to learn a single language like JavaScript or TypeScript. And with help of the single language, we can create real native app and we can publish it on App Store and Play Store. So like in native app, like when we are working on the iOS development, so we publish app on the App Store, and we when work on the Android native application we publish app on the Play Store. So in the same way in React Native we can publish app on the both store. So few people and few developers think that React Native is a newer version of React, although React Native does use it. But React Native is not a newer version of React. React Native is not equal to. So here, not equal to. React is not equal to React Native. So React and React Native is two different things. And in few minutes, we will also discuss the difference between React and React Native. So React Native is based on React and uses the single JavaScript code base to reuse the code on various platforms. So actually, React Native is based on the React. Because in React Native, under the hood, we use the same development structure we use in React. So React Native is a combination of React and native component. So when we combine two things, React and native component, so it's the combination of the React Native. So React Native here is the combination of React plus native component. So if you have already worked on the React, so you know better that how states will be set in React, and if you have already worked on the native apps like iOS and Android, so you know already about the native component. So it is the combination of the two things. A developer of React, so you can learn also React Native after learning of some native components, and a native developer like Android or iOS, so you can also learn React Native after learning the React.js basic concepts. So here is the few differences between React React.js and React Native. So React is also called React.js. So React.js is a JavaScript library. So it's a library, and React Native is a framework. So in framework, we use inbuilt libraries of React.js. React.js is used for front-end web development, and React Native is used for mobile application development, cross-platform mobile application. So React.js is used for front-end web development, and React Native is used for mobile application development, or you can say cross-platform mobile application, because we are creating in React Native multiple platform apps. So React.js developed by Facebook engineering team, and React Native is also developed by same Facebook engineering team. So React uses HTML, CSS, JavaScript to create interactive user interfaces, and React Native on the other hand uses native UI component and APIs to create mobile apps. In React.js, we use HTML component. If you have worked on the HTML, so you know better about the HTML tags like div, span, AAP. So all tags we use in React.js. But in React Native, we use native components. So if you have already worked on the native apps like Android or iOS, so you know better about what is text, what is view, what is label. So all these things we use in native application. So the next question is that why choose React Native? So React Native is largely based on JavaScript, which is web development technology. So JavaScript developer can create mobile app with React Native. So it is the plus point for the web developer who is already working on the web development and already know about JavaScript. So JavaScript developer can also create mobile app with React Native, because React Native uses JavaScript as a language for mobile application. So React Native is an excellent choice for mobile app development due to its cross-platform functionality, fast performance, and simplicity. So this saves developer time and eliminate the need to learn complicated languages such as Java, Objective-C to create an app. So I think React Native we should use, because React Native is an open source and trusted, because it is created by Facebook. Here is some advantages and feature of React Native, why we use React Native for mobile application development. So first feature is that code reusability. So it's the feature, or you can say the advantages of the React Native, because core feature of any cross platform development framework is code reusability. So if you are using any other cross platform development framework, so you know that code reusability is the core feature. So if you are using Flutter, Ionic, Xamarin, so all multi-platform or cross-development platform uses code reusability, because single code you can use on multiple platforms. So in React Native, we can almost all the code throughout different platform. This feature saves plenty of time and reduce cost. So the second advantage is, you can say, the NPM, Node Package Manager repository support. So it's the, you can say, other advantages of React Native. NPM is a repository of pre-made libraries that developer can use working with React Native framework. The installation process is always headache, especially for new buyers. React Native uses Node Package Manager for installation, and it is fairly easy to use. So NPM is a repository of pre-made libraries, and developer can easily use it. And React Native is a framework, so installation process is always headache, and especially when we add new packages into the React Native. So with the help of the NPM, we can easily add the new packages into the framework. So this feature makes the development process much faster, allowing React Native developer to upload the code pattern from NPM library. So with help of the NPM libraries, developer can easily add their libraries, their packages into the framework. So another advantage of React Native is open source. So open source code are usually stored in public repositories and shared publicly. So React Native is designed to be publicly accessible. Anyone can see, modify, and distribute the code as they see fit. You know better that with open source, the open source code are usually stored in public repositories, so anyone can use it, can modify it according to their need. So with its open source feature, in just a couple of years, it became one of the top solutions used for mobile development. So next feature and advantages of the React Native is port reloading feature. So it is the next best advantages of the React Native. So it means that developer can see the changes in their code instantly without recompiling the app. So it allows developer to see the changes they make the code in real time or simulate. So you know that when we work on native apps like iOS and Android, so when we make some changes, so after running the application or reloading the application, we can check our changes. But in React Native provide the port reloading feature. So with port reloading feature, you can check your changes instantly after saving your code. So when you change something and save, so instantly you can check the changes on simulator or emulator if you are working on Android app. So it's the very important feature of React Native. So it works by injecting the updated code into the running app without restarting it or losing its state. Without restarting the application, you can check your changes in the application. So cheaper compared to native app. So it's also another advantage of the React Native. So here we do not need to create two separate applications for Android and iOS from scratch. So it allows us to reuse the code and avoid hiring two different teams for development. This can save twice the cost for its users. So you know that if you are working in native application, so for Android and iOS, so two different teams work for the Android application and one for the iOS application. So in React Native, we can create application with single team, so it reduces the cost. So it's cheaper compared to native apps. Powerful user interface provide app interface fast and responsive using React JavaScript library. So we use here React JavaScript library. So it also simplifies the layout of user interface with its tool. The another feature and advantage of the React Native is large community support. So in today's date, it has approached over 50,000 active contributors, and in future it can be greater than 50,000. And Facebook engineers are constantly developing and updating the platform. This makes it easier for users to access expert support. Facebook engineers are constantly working on the platform and improving day by day, so it provides large community support. So React Native has some disadvantages also. Performance is still a little lower than in native application. So it means that React Native is not able to use all feature of specific platform. So if we are creating application for iOS, so React Native cannot access all feature of iOS platform. And if we are creating application for Android, so React Native is also not access all native feature. So some performance difference is showing in application because it's a cross-platform application. So when we compare it with the native application, so performance is still little lower than in native application. So second is that difficult to debug. React Native application is very hard to debug. Developer must have sound knowledge of native platform. So if you already have worked on the native app like iOS or Android platform, so it's easy for the developer who have already worked on the native platform. But for the beginner or the other developer who have not worked on the native platform, so it's very hard for debug. Not efficient for complex interfaces. So React Native is known for its efficient UI rendering. It may not match the performance of fully native application in certain scenarios, like when handling complex animation or heavy computation tasks. So sometimes React Native is not efficient for complex interfaces. Top popular app built with React Native and using React Native platform, so like Facebook, Instagram, Flipkart, Skype, Walmart, so all these companies in today's date are using React Native. So React Native is a very popular framework, so you can use it. So I hope this video is very helpful for understanding the basics of React Native. So if you like this video, please like, share and subscribe the channel. Thanks for the watching.